Do you ever scroll until a game ad pops up and you think, I want to create my own mobile game? Well, I did. I know. I hear your questions. Why would someone want to publish a mobile game but they don't really create games and don't know much about it? Well, I just wanted the answer to a simple question. Would a single person download my game? Let's find out. First, we'll have to find some game engine, you know, to create the game. So, let me research the best game engines in the market. There we go. Good enough for Google. Good enough for me. And you might be wondering, when you have never used a game engine before, where do you even start? Well, you just have to go to their page and read a lot of documentation. Then, after a lot of digging, reach this little section called Your First 2D Game, and things started getting interesting. You know what they say, learn by doing, explore your own ways. Well, this was basically it. This showed us how to create a little squid game where you have to avoid touching enemies to survive. I don't want to say I'm good or anything, but if I can do this to a gorilla, this game is too easy. Leaving my incredible gaming skills aside, until this point, we just have been following tutorials. I feel like I haven't internalized how do you actually create a game in Godot. So, with my newly acquired Godot knowledge, I went to the drawing board and decided to create a test game from zero, just to revisit all the concepts. But, which type of game, you ask? Well, back in the day, there was this popular game called Doodle Jump, where you had to jump vertically from platform to platform to improve your score. You also had some power-ups and enemies, but forget about those for now. We just want to build a test game. So, we start by creating a project and adding the basic gameplay mechanics. We have some platforms that we can bounce on and a player, which in our case is a red square, because why not? And things got serious. We changed the resolution to vertical and added some spacing to the platforms. This way, we can visualize how playable the game is and make some changes. After creating the starting screen and adding some more platforms, our game currently looks like this. If you know me and my history, you should know that all of that is hard-coded, which makes this game very limited. If you want to improve this, we need a way to reliably generate a valid platform position so that the player can always keep climbing. So, imagine this. You have your player bouncing, and based on the last platform, you want to determine where you can place the next platform so that the player can reach. How can we do that? Well, the basic info we need to look at is how high the player can jump and how far he can move horizontally. And if we connect the two farthest points, we obtain an area reachable by the player. Amazing, I know. And with a little bit of coding magic, we now have an infinite game. We said this was going to be a mobile game, so let me throw a score counter and some touch controls. Much better. Now, we need to get this game working on a phone. And luckily for us, Godot has some easy exporting feature that allows us to build an APK file. This file can be run on an Android phone to install the app. And no, of course I didn't spend 2 hours trying to get the right JDK version installed with Android Studio. Another noob. It took me 4. But forget about that. We have our game installed on our phone. Let's try it out. Okay, let's change the orientation. Okay. The game technically doesn't work, but it's a test game, so I'm not going to fix it. Instead, we're going to make RedCar go fast. RedCar go fast, we first need RedCar. So, using the basic Godot rectangles, I build this thing. And of course, I make it move, so then it can go fast. Okay, great, but as you should know from my past games, I'm kind of an artist. And this rectangle thing is too basic. So you know what time it is. Liber Sprite! To be honest, I don't have the footage of how I created our final car. It's just a shame, but OBS decided to record a static screen. So here's the creation of the circuit tiles. First, I started by creating four tiles and mixing them together to get these results. But it felt too dull, so I took some time and did my best to improve the visuals. And after about 2 hours, I ended up with this tile palette. Now we just need to combine it into a circuit. Add a little bit more code, some collision detection, and voila! We now have this game. But although running in circles is fun, timing it is funnier. Still, the intention is to play this on a phone. So let me just add some touch controls and some basic menus. So this is the final game. Exciting, I know. You know, I had a mission. I wanted to publish the game to the Play Store. But as I went through the process, things got worse and worse. I had to pay $25, Google took all my personal data. They required me to upload a new format, which made me change the SDK again and lose another 2 hours. That wasn't the worst. After going through all that, I saw one obstacle that I could not surpass. The new testing scheme. Can someone tell me for what reasons in 2023 Google requires all apps on the Play Store to be tested by at least 20 people before they can be uploaded? I already gave them all my data. So at the moment, I'm waiting to see how I'm going to get 20 people to test my game. If you want to help out, I will probably leave some instructions in the description as how you can become a tester. Oh yeah, and this is the screen recording of the game being played from my phone. Subscribe!